think naturally, you know. People do that, especially if you're in a niche market. If you're in a niche market, there may not be, you know, hundreds of sites advertising. You can get top 10 just by nature, right. You know, in a niche market. My people, there's, you know, around 30 people. Compared to other industries, it's like unheard of. No competition. But at the same time, the people that are in it, you know, they're getting sophisticated with the search per click. So I am having to bid. For example, 30 cents or 20 cents or 10 cents. You come to Yahoo, type in piano lessons. Well, I want to appear first place, second place, or third place. So I tell, you know, Yahoo by way of Overture. Yep. Overture and Google, they have these pay-per-click search engine programs where you can basically bid 10 cents. So if he clicks, you click on my site, I pay 10 cents. But at the same time, you come to my site, sign up for lessons, and you become a potential buyer. So it's a numbers game, and that's why I love it, because through a SocialTrack, you know, your affiliate tracking software, I use that in conjunction with my own advertising efforts, because that lets me know if something is working. I'm not going to dish out $1,000 yet $10 if it's not working. I don't care if it's a penny. I'm not going to dish it out if it's not working. So I use tracking mechanisms like yours, and it lets me know. When someone types in piano lessons, one out of every 30 to 50 people will buy. That's amazing. That's like 2 out of 100 people.
Right.
So while it costs 15, 20 cents for you to get here, you do the calculations, that's about $20 per every 100 people. But I found out that two people will buy my $70 course.
Right.
So it doesn't take a genius to figure out that $140 is made by $20. So
right.
$20, $140.
Making $120.
Yeah.
For every 100 visitors.
Oh, yeah. And the product doesn't even cost that much to reproduce. So a lot of that is just pure profit.
So let me just go over this again, just make sure all the viewers here understand it. So you use search engines in the beginning, and you got, you know, natural ranking, which we call it, which is getting placed in search engines that are free search engines. It costs you nothing to get in there, and you get ranked high. Then you decide, I want to be at the top no matter what. I want to be number one, number two, number three.
Right.
And so you just pay for it, and you pay for it through pay-per-click. So you go to places like Overture or Google, and you bid on those placings, and you can actually be what we call a featured listing on Yahoo. So you go into Yahoo, and you type in piano lessons. The first three listings are featured listings, which means they're like you, that you paid for those.
Right.
And you could be in the one top three places if you've bid enough money to be in those top three places.
Right. And it's important to note, that's just one word. Piano lessons. But then you got piano chords, piano tips, free piano lessons. I mean, you take it word for word.
Right.
And if you're really serious, you know, with the SocialTrack, you can make each one of those words its own affiliate, you know, or tracking. It can have its own number, you know, so to speak.
So before we go any further, because people may be not understanding how that works. So basically, you use a program called the SocialTrack, which, and just to confirm on all this, you use a program called the SocialTrack to allow you to track those keywords to make sure you can actually track how many people are coming through Yahoo on that keyword, and then how many people are buying, and you can actually see that number. So it goes, oh, wait, I know I had 100 people come through, two bought, and a SocialTrack will tell you how many people came through on that keyword, how many people bought for each individual keyword. You can say, oh, these five keywords are making me lots of money, and these two keywords aren't making me lots of money, so you're gonna ditch those two keywords and keep these other five.
That's exactly what I did.
Good.
In fact, I mean, I was using the word piano for a while, and a SocialTrack let me know that piano wasn't pulling. It was one out of 300 people, and I was paying, you know, 30 to 40 cents, so that was just wasted money.
Right.
You know, it took, you know, a strong man to say, you know, while piano was a popular word, and while it looks good to be number one for piano, I am the man. It just takes a smart person to say, you know, if it's not pulling, you know, you need to get out.
Yep.
So, you know, I remain top 20, top 10 for piano in the natural listings, but I'm just not going to pay for something that's not pulling. And I have about, you know, 300 words now that are pulling for me. And like I said,
and SocialTrack tracks all those, right?
Yeah, they track it all
automatically. It just gives you a report showing what words are being tracked, how many click-throughs, and how much money is being made, so you know how much profit you made.
Right.
All automatic. So you have to track it individually, do all the math on paper. It just takes care of it all automatically.
It just
takes a button.
Yep, and then the good thing about it is, like, you know, since the SocialTrack does affiliates too, you know, at the end of the month, I'll have so many affiliates, you know, that get paid. You come, you sell my product, I pay you. Then I'll have so many of my own tracking links. So it's like, you know, 75, you know, accounts, and 50 of them are my own words. It's like, wow, that's what I profit. And I don't even have to cut them a check because, you know, I've already done the advertising. So it's like it allows me to keep this, you know, in check to the point where I don't spend more than I have to. And at the same time, I use it for my affiliate program, pay for performance.
Yeah.
That's different than pay-per-click. That's my next strategy. Right. I pay per performance.
Affiliate programs.
Affiliate programs, right. Which means you come to my site, you have a piano supply site. You come, you say, I want to sign up. You sell my product, $70, I'll give you $20 to $25. So you make a business by not even owning the product or having to worry about customer service. So you win.
Yeah.
I win because I don't necessarily have to pay you per visitor, but I pay you when you make a sale.
Right. You have nothing to lose.
Nothing to lose
at all.
They send
you 10,000 visitors and nobody buys. You don't pay them a dime.
Yeah, I don't pay them a dime.
But let's pause there for a second and let's talk about it. For people you know that are viewing that may not know what an affiliate program is, and there's probably a few of you out there that don't know. We hope that you do, but if you don't, that's okay. If you actually have the SocialTrack software, the affiliate program software, people can come and join your affiliate program automatically. It will email them all the information they need to link to you, and on their website or in their emails, they'll actually go and link to you through a special URL. It could be a banner, it could be a recommendation, it could be in an email, it could be a lot of different things that they're going to link to you. And every time that someone links through from their website or their email to your site, it's tracked, and they can see how much, you know, how many visitors have gone through. You can see how many visitors have gone through, and then from that, if anybody buys, you pay them a healthy commission. The advantage of that is, of course, you don't pay them any money until they make a sale. So it's impossible for you to lose money. You're not paying them for visitors. You're paying them only when someone makes a sale. Just for people that don't know what affiliate programs are. So it's a very, very powerful strategy.
Oh, yeah. And it's awesome. I mean, I can attribute 30% of my, you know, revenue to an affiliate program. I have affiliates now that are making sales. I mean, nothing like yours, but sales like $3,000 a month. I mean, for a little guy like me, one person... Yeah. You know, and I'm giving them their cut, you know, they're getting, you know, nearly $1,000, even more, you know, and then I'm keeping the rest, you know, to go back into my affiliate program and whatever I use it for. But it's a wonderful system. It's a wonderful model. I mean, it goes all day. I mean, I can support 1,000 affiliates, 10,000 affiliates with this model. And the only thing I would have to worry about to make sure everything's in place, can I support the business, you know?
Yep.
Can I support what it brings me?
Yep.
You know, the affiliates is no problem.
Right.
You
good
know?
Problem to have.
It's a good problem. You know, you have bad problems and you have good problems. Too much business, that's a good problem.
One thing you said here in the past, earlier in the interview, is that, you know, everyone starts with no traffic. You started with zero traffic. Mm-hmm. You know, we started with zero traffic. Tell me about some other things that you've done here that you know, other tools you've used to generate traffic to your site.
There's this one tactic I use, easing, advertising, sponsorship. That could be a number of things. And keep in mind, these are other people's lists, okay? They build up a list of piano players, for example, you know, a couple of thousand or more. And, you know, I'm like, wow, that's where my audience hangs out. Mm-hmm. My audience gets their emails. Mm-hmm. Why not put my website in front of my audience by way of something that's already in progress, already acting? So, you know, I go out, I find newsletters, you know, I might get a sponsorship ad. That's just like a little blurb on top. Learn to play piano by ear.
Right.
Click here, free lessons. It might be a solo ad. This is where that company agrees to send just your ad or your sales page to that entire list. I mean, think about it. If somebody already has a list of 30,000, you don't have to do any work. I mean, negotiate with the person a rate and send out this solo ad. You could bring in profits of literally tons of thousands of dollars just by one advertisement. The solo ads, the e-zine, sponsorships, other things you can do. People might have daily tips and things like that. Just sponsor them. You know, this daily tip is brought to you by hearandplay.com, right, where you can receive over 60 free lessons.
I think the great point behind that is that you actually have nothing. You can have no traffic to your website at all.
No traffic.
All you do is you go look for someone that has a big email list or big traffic. Either they have big traffic with your target audience. You use pop-unders and all these other different techniques. You can advertise on the website, of course, too. If you have an e-zine or a list, whether it be a newsletter, which is an e-zine, or some kind of a tips list or whatever, you can actually go and sponsor that or advertise in that and immediately get traffic to your website and start making money immediately without it ever starting from zero.
Right. And depending on your niche market, it might not even be that expensive because you're not dealing with like big major sites or, you know, you're not dealing with Fortune 500 companies. You're dealing with, you know, Joe, who found a good niche and has built a big list.
Right.
He might not even do any advertising.
Right.
This might be new to him.
You give him a couple $100. He's like, holy geez, a couple $100. That's great.
$50. He might be like, wow, he's willing to give me $50.
Yeah.
So, you know, depending on who, you know, this might be something new for him.
Yeah.
So you can get into it.
I've done that before. I still write checks to a couple people on that I started advertising with 6 years ago for my car book.
Right.
I told them I'd give them $10 a month. I still wrote them a check for $10 a month for my little banner for my car book on their site, and that's been years. I keep writing them a check for $10 every month.
Right.
Yeah, and it's cheap. I mean, we get so many sales from that. So Any last comments or other things you do to drive traffic to your website?
Other than the affiliate programs, the search engines, the pay-per-clicks, the pop-unders, I offer free email, and this is free, even free for me to offer free email.
Oh, wait, that's something I should explain because that's important. Not, in other words, you don't offer like a free newsletter. This is actually offering them free email, like Yahoo free email or Hotmail free email, like a free email account, right?
Oh, yeah.
Free email account.
Yeah.
So it's, now tell me about how that model works.
Yeah, first off, if you want a good email, come over to Here and Play. You know, basically, it's just like Yahoo. Google, you have your address book, your inbox, your folders. Mm-hmm. And basically, when they sign up for free email, it can be Corey Rudo at hearandplay.com.
Yep.
Now you have your own email. You can send, receive messages. But what happens is that every time you send out a message, just like Hotmail has their little one sentence blurb at the bottom, free email, Hotmail. Well, every message gets my two sentence, you know, free email provided by Hear and Play. Learn to play piano by ear. 60 free lessons.
Right.
So that's like, I mean, look how many impressions are going out. I have 3,000 people signed up.
Right.
Now, granted, not all 3,000 are on at one time, but a couple hundred sending, you know, a few emails a day, responding back and forth. That's thousands of impressions a day, and I've even tested that. I mean, people have come. That's viral marketing. I mean, I even made a new word. I call it viralization. You know, it's my fancy word to say, you know, sharing the word.
Right.
This is not my advertising efforts. This is just a common person sending an email and their friends saying, wow, free lessons.
Let's pause for a moment and talk about viral marketing. Viral marketing is something where your promotion virally, like a virus, it virally propagates without you doing anything. In his email situation, he actually allows people to use a free email account, and if he's not doing anything, they're just sending emails to their friends. They're actually, you know, promoting his product unknowingly, and all these emails that go out at the bottom, it promotes his product. So the more email they send, the more he gets promoted. He's not lifting a finger. So it's called viral marketing. It's a very powerful tool.
Yeah, it's like quantum growth. I mean, how many emails have you forwarded? I mean, now friends are forwarding email. You read, Hear and Play. You know, you forward it, Hear and Play. Oh, don't let it be like one of those big things like Pass It On, and
it
originated from Hear and Play. I mean, and it's free. You can go to companies like everyone.net. They'll get you hooked up. You know.
Next question would be, we talked about all these things. You've managed to get people there. How do you convert these people into customers?
Autoresponders. I think that's a magic word. And the feeling I must have felt when I just heard about this system of how to autorespond. I mean, I knew, even without doing it, I knew this was going to be something big. The ability to follow up with your customers without having to do anything. Corey, I'm not talking about having to sit down and type an email to you 5 days later. I'm talking about having already typed the email and the computer sending it out 5 days later. This is basically how it works. Okay, Corey, you come to my site, you sign up for free lessons. And I do a nice little process. See, I want more information from you, but I don't give you that, I don't tell you that right in the beginning. I just ask for your first name and email address on my main site.
Right.
I have a little menu that lets you choose a lesson, so that gets you excited.
Yeah.
You give me your first name, email. You become on my general list. You're on my general list now. And at that point, I take you to a second sign-up form, you know, and 70% of people will do this, so I'm not losing out too much. And even if you do close it, you're still on my general list.
Right.
Second form, how long have you been playing? When do you want to reach your goals? How long have you been playing? You know, where are you from? Just little things. What styles of music? Rock, gospel, jazz, blues.
Right.
And now I follow up with you as though that is really me sending it out to you.
Right.
7 days later, hi, Corey. Thanks for coming to my site. You came last Wednesday. Just want to see how you've been doing, you know. Just want to give you some heads up about what we offer. You said you wanted to learn rock music, you know, by
ear. And you're mail merging in rock music.
I'm mail merging rock music.
Right.
You told me, whether you remember it or not, you told me you want to play rock music.
Right.
I'm not God. I'm not just coming down and saying, you want to play rock music, you know. No, you told me whether they remember it or not.
Right.
So I'm merging it in, and my sentences are so general that, you know, let me give you an example. Since you've been playing for, and I'll merge in whatever you told me, I have little options, 1 to 6 months, 7 to 12 months, 2 years. Mm. Since you've been playing for 3 years, Corey, you're at a wonderful position to grow your piano playing.
Right.
Or since you've been playing for 1 to 6 months, Corey, you're at a wonderful position to improve your piano playing.
Right.
Corey, since you've been playing for 7 years, I mean, you still have a lot of growing to do. I merge these different things in there so the person's like, oh, you are telling the truth.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, more than that, they think that you're personally emailing them.
Oh.
Because there's so much detail. I mean, programs like MailLoop allow you to actually do that, to have these delayed autoresponders that will send out responses 3 days later, 7 days later, 20 days later, I mean, even a year later,
right,
and has sent out, you know, different autoresponses for different categories of people based on the questionnaire you're offering. I mean, we know both know that MailLoop does a lot more than that. I mean, it has the fact that it can, you know, it'll extract all your order information, put it in your database for you automatically. Right. It will answer some of your customer service email and sales email. It'll you know, allow you to send out all your newsletters automatically and take care of subscribed and unsubscribed for your newsletters, allow you to send out promotions automatically, all that kind of thing. I mean, that's just starting. We know it does a lot more than that, but you know, it's a piece of software that allows you to automate what you're talking about. It allows you to put in all this detail automatically to say, you know, the email that goes out 3 days later after someone subscribes to your free lessons will say, "Hi, John. Like you said, you know, notice you're into rock music. You know, how's it going with, you know, so on and so on. And notice you've been playing for 3 years. And you have so much more room to improve. It'll mail merge all these things in for you automatically, unlimited amount of fields." Mm-hmm.
Basically, it's all about personalization. Right. I try to personalize the email to the utmost. I mean, using the basic information they've already provided me. And basically, I follow up with lessons. Mm-hmm. Like, if you sign up for my chords progression, obviously, you want to learn chords. It's just, I mean, I'm not trying to give a piano lesson here, but just the pressing down of multiple notes at the same time, what makes songs. Mm-hmm. So I'll send them multiple chords. Mm-hmm. Like, "Hey, try this out, Corey. Mm-hmm. You say you want to play rock music. Here's a rock chord progression."
Right.
And they say, "Wow, he sent me all this good information." I get emails back saying, "Thank you, Jermaine. You're so helpful. Thank you for, I'm sorry, I was out of town. I couldn't get back to you right away." You know, you are so helpful.
Because they think you're sending these emails personally, right?
Yeah,
right.
And that's the intent. I want to help them. It's just that, you know, I can't send each one individually. Right. So technology allows me to do that. And
send thousands automatically.
It's probably more than 5,000 to 10,000 going out just today, you know, whether they're 7 day, 30 day. I'm sure there's people getting my 1 year autoresponder. It's funny because you said, you know, MailLoop allows you to do in a year or 2 years.
Right.
I say, you know, it's 1 year anniversary. I'll say, you know, "How's your piano playing?" I'll say, "It's been 1 year since you came to my site."
And the beautiful thing is that automatically set up the day they subscribe 1 year before. It's already queued up to go to a year from now. You don't have to even look at it. It's done already.
I can even merge the date. You know, you came here last December, or you came here last March, for that matter, signed up for lessons.
That's great.
You came here in the spring, or, you know, you came here in the winter. You know, I can do different things. I mean, I can even put salutation, like Mr., Mrs., Dr., you know. I can say Mrs. Griggs or Mrs. Thomas. I can do all kinds of things with personalization. It's just up to pretty much your own creativity.
And you plug your, as you create this rapport and conversation in this email with personalization, then you end up plugging your product saying, "This, your product can solve their problem."
Right,
you can help them play piano faster and easier and better.
Yeah. Give them samples, present the problem, present the solution, but it all always narrows down to my course. Everything's reducible to here. If you're serious, now I've given you all this free stuff. It's free for the taking, free for the asking, you know, but if you're serious, here's where you really need to go. Here's some videos that'll help you in gospel. Here's a course that'll help you in music theory. This will really improve your chords. And that's where ultimately I have some newsletters where I can convert 60% of the readers. I mean, 6 out of 10 people who get those chords are, I mean, feel, you know, encouraged to buy my product because of that rapport and because I've built relationship with them. And like you said, 7 exposures before someone will even consider your offer.
Right.
And so, you know, follow-up allows me to accomplish that.
So let's digress for a second and talk about, just kind of summarize what's happened. People come to your site, you offer them, you know, they can buy right there on your sales letter.
Oh, yeah.
Which is, and you have a sale, and you learn that from our course, and you know how to write sales copy now. Mm-hmm. But they can also subscribe to your free lessons.
Absolutely.
And that's what we're talking about. What we've been talking about here is when they subscribe to the free lessons, then you have autoresponders automatically follow up with them, you know, give them that, you know, talking to them personally, having lots of personal information, and end up showing them that if they're serious, they should go buy your course.
Right.
And you convert a lot of customers to that.
Right. Yeah. It's real basic. I don't even want to make it as complex. You know, basically 2 avenues. You come to my site, either you buy or you sign up for free lessons. That's at least what I want.
Right.
You know, more to buy, but of course, I know not everyone buys in the first exposure.
Right.
And then that's not unreasonable, you know. So I get you in the process, and eventually I want to get, whether you buy in 7 days, 30 days, or at least, you know, a year from now, you know, I want to get you in the process. I want to be a relationship with you.
The beautiful thing is it's all free. Email doesn't cost any money. So
it's
you can
free.
Go, right.
I mean, I'm glad. I tell my grandma, my mom, and everybody, I'm glad I was born in the 80s, you know, and have this opportunity to be on the internet, because if I was born 40 years ago, it would be so expensive to send out follow-ups, postcards, direct mail. I mean, it can get expensive. I can't talk from firsthand experience because I use email, and it's F R-E-E, free.
So now, one thing you brought up is email, and I actually want to kind of, you know, expand that a little bit, is that the lifetime value of a, you know this, the lifetime value of a customer is incredible. You don't care about them buying a $20 product today, because you know they may buy a $20 product today, but they may buy $1,000 in product over the next 1 year. So having that relationship and being able to email them again and again and build that rapport and have that relationship going as you're talking to them personally and sharing these details that they think are yours, you know, that you're being, that you're sending a personal email, creates that relationship and they'll buy from you again and again and again. Because we know that even getting away from your subscribers, talking about customers, you send out autoresponders when people become a customer. They become a customer and they buy something. Oh, yeah. You want to send an autoresponder 3 days, 7 days, 10 days, 20 days, even a year later to offer other solutions, whether it be your other products or whether it be someone else that you know has a great product and you recommend their product and you make some kind of affiliate commission.
Right, and I do some creative things with that, like 3 days. I tell them your product is on its way, your course is on its way. 15 days, how's your course? Mm-hmm. You know, here's our live chat, here's our message board link, you know, post any questions you have. Mm-hmm. We have consultations. I really make them feel that I care, and I do care. Mm-hmm. But, you know, follow-up allows me to do that. Right. I mean, you have all the resources. Here they are. You know, I follow up in 4 days, you know, letting them know it's on its way. 14, 15, letting them know, you know, how has it been going. And in 30, you know, since you bought the course, you might want to consider or you might be interested in these videos, you know. Now you got the written and the interactive form. Well, here's a visual form. And they go for it. I have people who have bought everything. I mean, it's to the point where I'll tell them about products coming out in the future, and they'll call me and say, well, what else do you have to offer? Well, ma'am, sir, we don't have anything else. Well, when are you coming out with something?
Isn't that a great call?
It's a great call, and they get an attitude.
They bought everything you have, and they're calling you, and they're actually upset that you don't have more they can buy.
Yeah, because, you know, I have to admit, sometimes I might lag and tell them, you know, I told them a product was coming out in January, and I haven't, you know, got it edited yet, but I mean, lately, cause of when is Gospel Keys 202? That's one of my newest products. Right. When is it coming out? How much is it going to cost?
Right.
What's going to be a little bit more than the previous product? Well, how much more? Oh, that's not bad. Well, let me know. Call me when it comes out.
Right.
So that lifetime value, you're absolutely correct. And I have some customers who are diehard. Whatever I come out with, it can be on rock and roll. They can hate rock and roll. They'll be converted because of my influence on them.
Creating that personalization through email and so on.
Yeah.
Let's talk about email. I mean, email is so powerful because one, it makes you look very professional, especially in your situation where it looks, you're looking like you're sending out all these individual personalized, you know, with very explicit details about them, personal details. It's very fast. You get fast response to send out an email. You can get a sale right there because they can respond to it and buy right away.
Right.
You can personalize it. As you know, you have incredible personalization abilities. You can develop a great relationship and they want to buy for maybe even 30 days, 60 days, 90 days from now. And it's cheap. It's free.
Oh, yeah. It's free.
I mean, I'll talk from experience too. I mean, there's not a time where we're doing our promotion if through our email list that, you know, if we do a promotion and make less than $100,000, we're pretty upset. So, I mean, there's times that in the past where we have literally, I've written an email in 30 minutes, written one email in 30 minutes, sent it out, and within 30 days, over $400,000 in business came in. 400 grand. I want to reiterate that, because that's not correct. That's $400,000 in pure profit.
Right.
We actually didn't even have the product. We wrote an email about domain names once.
Right.
We were recommending some other buddy's service, trying to help our customers out, saying there's a great new thing that's happening with domain names. You got to check this out because we're buying all we can right now because this new rule that came out.
Right.
We let all of our customers know, so you got to go buy them from this group over here. They bought over $1 million in domain names from this company, and we got an affiliate fee for all that.
We
ended up with a check for over $400,000 for an email that took me 30 minutes to write. That's the power of email. That's the power of creating that relationship, you're creating. So, like, I mean, it doesn't matter if you're a doctor, you're a lawyer, you're a professional, it doesn't matter what you're in, restaurant owner, you can use email. Okay. I mean, we're talking about things like, if you're a realtor and you have a new property for sale, if you have a list of your clients, you can email that to all your clients, have them calling you to sell a new property instead of you trying to have to hunt them down or call them all. If you're a tax attorney, you could remind everybody about when April 15th or their tax time is coming, remind them they need to do their retirement savings plan or whatever it may be. I mean, you have restaurant people that could remind their customers if you're gathering these email addresses from your customers to remind them about Valentine's Day is coming up and you'll offer them a special table for Valentine's Day because they're a very good customer. I mean, the list goes on. No matter what business you're in, email applies to you. When we're talking about, you know, internet businesses here,
right.
It doesn't matter what business you're in, email applies so you can make you more money.
And it's funny you say that because the house that I'm in escrow, I took a virtual tour of that online. I mean, I found out that's the house I wanted. I could see the view on the internet.
It's great. And
it was like this view here. I don't know if the camera's looking at it, but I mean, it's a nice view, and I could see that on the internet. And that realtor was at a great advantage for letting me see that. And even from my perspective as a customer, when I was online, the houses that had no pictures, I didn't want to be interested in
Absolutely.
Them. The ones that had virtual tours and these real estate agents who had gotten online and it looked to me that they knew what they were doing, you know, I was interested.
Not only that, but it gave you a great advantage. The fact that they understand your needs, and they put those pictures online so you could see and understand. They put that virtual tour.
Right.
So all you realtors out there, you just lost a sale of a good house if you weren't online. You just bought a house because that person, that realtor, had an online site that you were willing to go, wow, this really interests you, because you could search, you could go through 100 houses in a few minutes rather than having to spend months traveling around visiting all these houses.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's amazing the technology now, and you're a living example. You bought a house because you first viewed it on the internet and could see the view, and that sold you on it, so you went and saw the house.
Yeah, if that same house had no picture listed,
Wouldn't even look at it.
Yeah, it wouldn't even be in my destiny right now.
All you realtors, they got to listen to this.
My cleaners.
Get online. And we're talking about everything. I mean, even hotels. You see the picture of the hotel, the restaurant you want to go to, you see a picture. I now actually, when I want to take my wife out to a restaurant, you know, I want to go look at it. So I actually go look at what the setting is, and they see a picture of it online. If they don't show me a picture online, what kind of, you know, ambiance they have, I'm not going to take my wife there for a romantic date night
Absolutely.
Or something like that, right? So
Absolutely.
At the end of the day, you know, let's move on to another subject. Let's talk about, now we've talked about, you know, how to convert the customer. How do you actually, now you're getting orders, how do you handling that order? How are you taking care of it?
Okay, like I said, we've gone through a process. Right. Used to be to the fact where I would get an email, I print out that email, then I type up an address label, put it on there, wait in line at the post office. Since then, thank God, I've automated it. I got a sophisticated shopping cart, pennies on the dollar.